Gurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
Free bus for LKG to 8th standard.
Free hygienic and nutritious food.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Education Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12th, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12th, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
In continuation to the last class, in this class, we are going to discuss interference of light waves and Young's experiment. Interference of light waves and Young's experiment. Okay, ma? Right. In our last class, we focused and we discussed what is meant by coherence, what is meant by incoherence, and what is the basic principle for interference. That is what superposition principle. So, what is the superposition principle, and what is the condition for constructive interference and destructive interference? So, when two waves are going to interfere, when two waves are going to superimpose, if there is a path difference, if there is a phase difference, right? So, what happens to the resultant? What happens to the displacement of the resultant wave, right? And what about the intensity of the resultant wave? That and all we discussed, right? By taking two examples, one with 2 lambda phase path difference, and another one is minus 2.5 lambda path difference. At the same time, in one case the phase difference is 4 pi, in another case the phase difference is 5 pi. So with these two examples, we discussed where the constructive interference takes place, where the destructive interference takes place, what is the reason, what is the reason for constructive interference, and what is the reason for destructive interference. After completion of the discussion of these two examples, we derived a condition. That is what difference between two paths S1P and S2P is equal to n lambda. This is for constructive interference, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Similarly, the difference between S1P and S2P. So these are the paths where from sources the light is going to reach to the point, to the arbitrary point. So, where S1P difference S2P is equal to n plus 1 by 2 into lambda. This is the condition for destructive interference, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, right? So, afterwards, if there is a phase difference of phi, what is the condition to find the displacement of the resultant wave? That is, y is equal to 2a cos phi by 2 cos omega t plus phi by 2. There itself, the intensity of the resultant wave I is equal to 4 I naught cos square 5 by 2. 4 I naught cos square 5 by 2. So these two things, just now I told you, the displacement of the resultant wave is 2a cos 5 by 2 cos omega t plus 5 by 2. And the intensity I is equal to 4 I naught cos square 5 by 2. So these two for the resultant waves, displacement and intensity, when there is a fixed phase difference phi. Suppose if this phase difference is changing continuously, if it is not fixed, right? So when the two waves are incoherent, then what about the intensity of the resultant wave, which is called as time average intensity distribution? That is, I is equal to 4 I naught into cos square 5 by 2, right? So that cos square 5 by 2 you have to keep in the brackets, angular brackets, right? So here finally you can say that I is equal to 2 I naught. The resultant intensity will be given by I is equal to 2 I naught. Okay. So starting of this class till now, I explained you what we discussed in our previous class. That is very important for us to discuss this class. Okay, so these two classes having a very close relation, right? Because in the last class, whatever we discussed, everything is need for us to discuss this class also, right? So the famous scientist Young's, right? So the famous scientist, British physicist Thomas Young, so like practically showed what is the interference pattern, what is the condition for that already we discussed, no? The condition for constructive interference and destructive interference we discussed, but now we are going to see interference pattern. So the dark band, bright band, what is the fringe width, okay, what is the condition for constructive interference and destructive interference in terms of fringe width, okay, that and all we are going to discuss in this class, right? Okay, so our class is interference of light waves and Young's experiment. Okay, right, here to observe the interference pattern we need two coherent sources, right? Okay, so how it is possible to get two coherent sources? Observe carefully. If we use two sodium lamps illuminating two pinholes, we will not observe any interference fringes. I'll repeat once again. If we use two sodium lamps illuminating two pinholes, we will not observe any interference fringes. Why? The light wave emitted from ordinary source, that is what sodium lamp, undergoes a sudden phase change with a time difference, with a time gap of 10 to the power of minus 10 seconds. Okay, so that is the reason the light waves which are coming out from two independent sources of light will not have any fixed phase relationship. When there is no any fixed phase relationship, we will say that the two waves are incoherent. Okay, so when this happens, right? So in the last class, in the previous class we discussed, so when there is a non-coherent, the intensities on the screen will be adding up to get the final intensity, right? So what I am saying is, in place of two pinholes, here we need two pinholes, ma. So why two pinholes means, okay, I'll go back little. Here we need two waves to observe the interference pattern, right? So when two waves are going to superimpose, based on the situation, based on the condition, we will get either dark band or bright band, maybe either because of coherent or non-coherent, okay? That will be different. So here two waves we need. But the question is, if you use two different sources, two sodium lamps, here we won't observe any interference pattern. The reason is, these two sodium lamps, listen carefully, both are sodium lamps only. Although there is no chance to observe the interference pattern because there is no fixed phase relationship, okay, right. Now Thomas Young gave a technique, that is what, to get the two waves having fixed phase difference, that is called as locking the phase. Fixed phase relationship means locking the phase, right? So how it is possible to get two waves having fixed relationship? He used one sodium lamp and he used an opaque screen having two holes. So the source of light is only one, but when the light ray is coming from here, so here it will pass through these two holes, then each pinhole will act like a source of light, right? But the light which is coming from these two pinholes, source is only one, no? That's why it is possible to get the two waves having fixed phase difference, okay, right? So here, whatever it may be, right, see this, the light waves spread out from S and fall on both S1 and S2. S1 and S2 then behave like two coherent sources, because light waves coming out, from S1 and S2 are derived from the same original source, and any abrupt phase change, abrupt means sudden, any sudden phase change in S will manifest in exactly similar phase changes in the light coming out from S1 and S2. The reason is only one thing, that is what the source is same. The source is same, right? That is the main thing here, right? So he covered, so the technique given by Thomas Young, providing us the two waves having fixed phase difference, okay, right, okay. Afterwards, you see here, you can see this picture, ma. So it is the source of light. So here it is the opaque screen. The distance between the two pinholes is small d. That is, one hole is S1, another hole is S2, and the distance between the opaque screen and the screen where the interference pattern you can observe is capital D, right? So you can see the lines, that is what interference, these lines are the resultant of these two waves, resulting interference of these two waves, right? Okay, so it is like x-axis and it is like y-axis, it is like center point O, that is what the center for the interference pattern. Okay, so this is the Young's experiment. He arranged to produce interference pattern, okay, right. Now we can see other one, ma. This is what here it is the screen, it is what G G dash is the screen where you can observe the interference pattern due to the interference of two waves coming from two pinholes, S1 and S2. The distance between S1 and S2 is small d, and S is the source of light, and capital D is the distance between the opaque screen and the screen where we are going to observe the interference pattern, right? So it is like, right, you know what is x-axis, what is y-axis, what is z-axis, you know. So this is the distance x from arbitrary point to the center point of the interference pattern, right? So this arbitrary point will change. It may be here, it may be here, it may be here, wherever it is, right? So this is the path S1P and this is the path S2P. So this is the path in which light comes from S1 to the arbitrary point P, and this is the path where light comes from S2 to the arbitrary point P, right? So it is S1P and it is the S2P, right? So yesterday in our previous class, I showed you, right, when two waves are going to generate at the same time, right, after certain time, as time passes, the two waves are going to interference. So waves means which constitute crest and trough. Regarding the second wave also, crest and trough. When the crest of the first wave falls on the crest of second wave, when the crest of first wave falls on the trough of the second wave, what will happen? So when the displacement will be added up, right? When the displacement will be cancelled, right? In this area, yesterday I showed you one picture. I mean, last class I showed you one picture, right? So here that you have to keep in mind, right? When crest fall on crest, you can expect maximum, no? When crest fall on crest, you can expect maximum in case of constructive interference. When trough fall on trough also, you can expect the maximum, right? Suppose if crest fall on trough, what will happen? It will become as zero when there is equal amplitude. When trough fall on crest also, the same thing will happen. So what I am saying is wave means which constitute crest and trough. Similarly, the second wave also having crest and trough. So how both are going to interference? What about the displacement? I mean, what about the amplitude, right? And how they are going to interfere? These are all very important to get maximum and minimum intensities. Maximum and minimum intensity. How to find the intensity of the resultant wave? In our last class we discussed. That is what in case of different examples and the condition also, right? That condition also gives us the resultant intensity, right? Okay. Here you just concentrate on maximum and minimum intensities. Maximum and minimum intensities, okay? Right. See this. The spherical waves coming from S1 and S2 will produce interference fringes on the screen GG'. The positions of maximum and minimum intensities can be calculated by the following process, right, that we are going to discuss now. Next, we are showing this maximum and minimum intensities on the screen, right? So this is the point, this is the arbitrary point P on the line GG', right, to correspond maximum. For example, first we are going to discuss maximum. For maximum we must have, for maximum intensity on the screen at a point, we must have the difference in S2P and S1P is equal to n lambda. N is equal to 0, 1, 2 dash dash dash. Suppose if n is equal to 0, what will happen? S2P minus S1P is equal to 0, no? Then S2P is equal to S1P, no? Then what will happen? This is the point. Here the P will be here. So this is S1P and this is S2P. Then there we will get maximum intensity. Maximum intensity. Am I right? This is the condition in our previous class also we discussed. That only we are writing here. But to get maximum intensity, this is the condition to be followed by S1P and S2P. That is S2P minus S1P is equal to n lambda. N is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 dash 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 dash. That is like equation number 1. That is like equation number 1. Okay, right. Now we are going to discuss the next one. See here, S2P whole square minus S1P whole square is equal to, right. So what is S2P? This is S2P, right. What is S1P? This is the S1P. You just imagine S2P means this is the S2P, no? It is what? D. It is what? Small d. It is what? X. So S2P means this is ma. So this is what? Capital D. And it is what? X plus D by 2. This is D by 2. This is D by 2. So it is also D by 2. X plus D by 2 whole square. S2P means you just take here right angle triangle. S2P is the hypotenuse. Hypotenuse square is equal to side square plus side square. So that here D square plus X, D square plus X plus D by 2 whole square minus S1P. This is the S1P, Emma. It is capital D only, but what about this X minus D by 2? So D square plus X minus D by 2 whole square, right? So if you do this calculation mathematically, even this relation also we are writing mathematically. So if we cancel some of the things and finally the resultant will be like this. It is 2XD, 2 small x small d, right? So here S1 S2 is equal to small d, OP is equal to X, that's already you know, and we represented and we showed on the figure. See here. Now S2P minus S1P is equal to, right? It is what? A square minus B square formula, no? So A square minus B square is equal to A plus B into A minus B. A plus B into A minus B. So I am writing like that. Then what will happen? S2P minus S1P is equal to 2 small x small d divided by S2P plus S1P. S2P plus S1P. Okay. Now this S2P plus S1P, this S2P plus S1P, I am going to replace with 2 capital D. 2 capital D. Is it possible to replace? Yes. That I'll explain you. You just focus here. If small x comma small d is double less than when compared to capital D, then negligible error will be available. Negligible error will be introduced when S2P plus S1P is replaced by 2 capital D. For these two things, for these two things with negligible amount of error, you can replace S2P plus S1P by 2 into capital D. It's okay, no? Okay, even we are going to take some example also. See here, it is 0.1 centimeter, ma. It is 100 centimeter, it is 1 centimeter. Then you just calculate S2P plus S1P. Then what will happen? It is approximately 200.01 centimeter, right? So if you take these values and then if you calculate S2P plus S1P, it will be 200, okay, almost 200 centimeters, right? See, what about 2 capital D? 2 capital D. Capital D is 100 centimeters. 2 capital D is also 200 centimeters, no? So these two are same, no? S2P plus S1P is equal to 2 into capital D. Then no problem for us to replace, right? So that we are replacing S2P plus S1P with 2 capital D, right? You just write here 2 capital D. Then what will happen? 2 will get cancelled. Then S2P minus S1P is approximately equal to x small x into small d by capital D. Small x into small d by capital D, right? Okay. Next, at the same time, right, so here he also mentioned the error. It is 0.005% error. Okay. So even S2P minus S1P is approximately equal to small x small d divided by capital D, then xd by d is equal. See, what is the S2P minus S1P for maximum? N lambda, no? Right? So S2P minus S1P is approximately equal to xd by d. So xd by d is equal to n lambda. Xd by d is equal to n lambda. So here itself, you can write x as a subject, ma. Xn, x is equal to, xn is equal to n into lambda d by d. So lambda is the wavelength of the light. Capital D is the distance between the opaque screen and the screen on which interference pattern will take place. And small d is the distance between the two slits, which gives us two light waves. Two light waves, okay, here to get the interference pattern, right? N is equal to 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2, etc. For constructive interference, observe carefully what we are writing here. We are writing n lambda. N lambda means for constructive interference for the maximum intensity. Suppose if you put x1, n is equal to 1, then lambda d by d. If you put x2, 2 into lambda d by d. If you put x3, 3 into lambda by d, like that. Okay, right. Afterwards, xn is equal to, in some other way, xn is equal to n plus 1 by 2 into lambda capital D by small d. This yesterday we discussed, last class we discussed. That is what the condition for, that is what destructive interference. S2p minus S1p is equal to S2p minus or S2p difference S1, S1p difference S2p is equal to n plus 1 by 2 into lambda. That we discussed in our last class, right? So from that here you can write that value, right? That is what, here you can write it as xt by d. Xt by d is equal to n plus 1 by 2 into lambda, you can write here. For destructive interference, you can write here. For constructive interference, x small d by capital D is equal to n lambda. For destructive interference, small x small d by capital D is equal to n plus 1 by 2 into lambda. If you write that one, based on that, you can write the expression for xn. That is n plus 1 by 2. Into n plus 1 by 2 into lambda capital D by small d. Lambda capital D by small d, where n is equal to 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2 for destructive interference. For destructive interference. Okay, right. Now, after getting the condition for constructive interference and destructive interference, okay, now What is the interference pattern on the screen? What about the dark and bright bands appear on the screen, right? So the dark and bright bands appearing on the screen are called fringes. And these two equations, this is one equation and this is another equation, these two equations shows that the dark and bright fringes are equally spaced and the distance between two consecutive bright and dark fringes, the distance between two consecutive bright and dark fringes is given by. So that is beta. It is called as fringe width, which is called as fringe width, that is beta is equal to xn plus 1 minus xn. xn plus 1 minus xn, that is equal to lambda into capital D by small d. So this is a important question for board point of view. It is 5 marks, very very important question. That is what Young's double slit experiment. And we can also say that deriving an expression for fringe width, deriving an expression for fringe width. Okay, here you can also see the pattern for rough diagram, right? Here I drew some pattern, right? It is what bright band and a dark band. So it is a dark band and it is also dark band, dark band, dark band. Middle of these dark bands we have bright bands. If you see that the central here also central ma, so just it is a rough diagram, so you please see the textbook, right? So it is a central and it is also central. Central we have bright band, so that is what it indicates, that the maximum intensity, maximum intensity, the central point O, the central point will be O, the central point O will be bright because S1O is equal to S2O, S1O is equal to S2O, otherwise S1P is equal to S2P. When S1P is equal to S2P, what about N value? N value is 0, no? N value is 0, right? So if we consider the line perpendicular to the plane of the paper, here perpendicular to the plane of the board and passing through O, then all points on this line will be equidistant from S1 and S2, so that we will have a bright central fringe. Bright central fringe, which is a straight line. This is that what the straight line as shown here. Okay, so like that you can determine the shape of the interference pattern on the screen, whatever it may be, whether it is the bright band or dark band. Okay, so it's not completed. We'll continue in the next class also. But please keep in mind what we discussed in this class. In this class, we focused on Young's experiment, right? So to observe the interference pattern, the two waves must have fixed phase difference. If we use two sodium lamps, we cannot get interference pattern because the two sodium lamps acts like a incoherent sources. So that the idea given by Thomas Young is very useful for us. That is what using one source of light, having two pinholes for an opaque screen. The waves which are emanating from two pinholes acts as a two coherent sources. Then you can see the interference pattern. This is the condition for maximum intensity, right? So this we are writing in terms of, that is what x, that is the distance of arbitrary point from central axis and distance between the opaque screen and the screen on which interference pattern will take place, and the distance between the two slits, that is what x into small x into small d by capital D, right? Here this is the condition for constructive interference and this is the condition for destructive interference, so that you can identify where the maximum intensity takes place and where the minimum intensity takes place, so that you can decide where the bright band will be formed and where the dark band will be formed. Okay, we'll continue in the next class. Thank you.